60-plus antique dealers under one roof, 5 floors, acres of stuff. You'll get your step count in today, no problem. I love an antique centre. You just don't know what you're going to find.
Hi there. How you doing?
Hi. Nice to meet you. Hello there.
Are you all right to wander around with us?
Yes, of course.
Just give me some prices on a few things as we go,
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Absolutely.
Might as well start in the first room.
There are 5 floors of different dealers, so plenty to rummage through. But straight away, Drew spots something interesting.
Oh, hello, look at that.
That's a really nice casting,
that's
isn't it?
Dead right as well,
yeah.
Isn't it?
I see a really well-modelled cast iron lion. Great size. And now so much more than a simple doorstop. It's a little piece of art now, isn't it? Look wonderful on a mantelpiece.
This cast iron doorstop is English and dates from the mid-19th century. Quality doorstops were a status symbol for the upper classes, and lions symbolised royalty and power. This could be worth around £350.
Love him. His hands are slightly, the mould's slightly gone on the face, but yeah, the rest of it's good. OK, 100 quid, what can you do that one for?
Yeah, that would be 90.
OK, so it's little discounts.
Yeah.
All right, fine, we'll take him.
It's a deal. Marvellous. Thanks very much.
A great piece. I'd have probably paid double.
Drew has everything from glassware to furniture to pick through. He's in his element.
Oh, it's lovely. This is good. I mean, this is good stuff. It's got all sorts in here. That frame's gorgeous, isn't it? Look at that. How beautiful is that? Say if that's 85, what sort of money would it be to me?
85, as a rule of thumb, if it's under £100, it's roughly 10%. That's at 88, we could definitely do 75 for that.
Antique centres are often the ideal places to hunt down the hidden one-off pieces that Drew knows will entice his customers.
That's nice.
The Buddha head,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, quite like that. 50 quid.
All right. It's a deal.
Marvellous.
And he can't wait to get stuck in.
75 we can do that for.
Yeah.
OK, deal. Marvellous. Thank you.
No point in not having that, is there? That would be stupid not to buy that. Great, 44 quid.
Deal.
Deal. Cool. This is one of my favourite rooms. When I first started coming here, it was a bit more of your bog standard sort of antique centre. I'd have to have a good price on that one.
Well, straight away I can say 140.
But it's morphed into something more than that these days. So let's pay them the 140.
Okay, excellent. Yeah, let's fine. Do that. Thanks very much.
It's like an antique theme park, isn't it? Can't believe my eyes. Look at that.
Beautiful, isn't it?
That's just lovely. God, that's beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, we've got a ticket price of 585.
This cast iron garden table is early Victorian, based on a previous Georgian design. It has a triform base of moulded acanthus leaves, which symbolise enduring life. This could fetch around £650, but if Drew wants to knock significant money off, assistant manager Philip will need to get the dealer to agree.
What makes that? It's obvious, it's one thing, it's the colour. Maybe 100 years ago, somebody painted it green and then just left it. It's wonderful, but it ain't cheap. The price, though, I can't get to. It's just under 600 quid. There's just no way. What's this guy like on doing
the
deals?
The price I can give you without making any phone calls is 500.
Mm. I really want it. It's just stand out beautiful, isn't it? There's not a line out of place on it, is there?
Yeah, it's perfect.
I can go to 450 and I can't go anymore.
Right.
Needs to start with a 4 to make myself feel better.
Excellent, yeah. I'll go and do the grilling.
As the assistant manager, Philip, is negotiating on behalf of the individual dealers, He needs their OK for any large drops in price.
Some things I just have to own them. I want that to go through my hands. I want my clients to see that, have the opportunity to buy it.
Right. I've worked a bit on your behalf.
Yeah.
So I hope that you'll be pleased with it. £450. Absolute best.
Sold.
I thought you might like that.
Thank you.
Good.
Just the colour, isn't it?
Yes,
and
fantastic.
It's so sculptural. Beat that. It's wonderful. I'm very, very pleased with it.
Drew's bought 7 pieces from different dealers, and there's another stall on the ground floor whose wares he wants to check out.
I like this room.
The lady that has this room has been with us, just over a year now. So
okay.
Not very long, but she was so keen to come in when the room became vacant.
Yeah. The price is on everything. Nope.
Well, she keeps stocking up with new stock.
Yeah.
She's in such a hurry to get things in
that
she sometimes takes a little while to come up with prices, but we can always give her a call.
OK.
Actually, the last piece she had in was a Howard chair, genuine, with stamped on the casters.
Yeah.
And that didn't last 5 minutes, actually.
What did she describe that one as?
Howard-type chair.
Howard-type chair. Mm. Can we get a price on that?
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
I'll give her a call for
Great
you,
stuff.
No problem.
Thank you. I'll just check it out, make sure it's still working.
Drew's passion for combing through every nook in the hunt for choice antiques sometimes yields a major result.
It's a Howard.
Is it?
Is it on the leg, on the stamped? No, on the caster, and the caster's correct for it, and the leg, the turned front leg is dead right, 1880.
Drew is certain this armchair is an original Howard & Sons, one of the most celebrated Victorian furniture makers. Bona fide Howard chairs can be identified in several ways, including a stamp on the caster cup or wheel. They can be worth around £3,000.
Your Howard-type chair, we need a price on it. It hasn't got a label on it.
The dealer who's put this chair in here doesn't have it marked as a Howard, doesn't have it marked at all.
OK, I'll pass that on. Bye.
Well, that's their fault, not mine.
Right, so I've finally got a price for you. The very, very best price is £1,800. It would have been £2,002.
Is it worth pushing her to £1,500?
I can put my neck on the block and say 17 would be OK. But that means another phone call if you want me to do that.
For 100 quid, yeah. Try her at 16.
OK, will do.
Try her at 16.
No problem.
Yeah. The casters are marked. The legs are all correct. The back legs are stamped up. It's dead right.
OK, I can tell him I've done my damnedest then. OK, thank you. As expected, the absolute death is 70.
1,700?
Yes.
Yep, fine. You're
OK, that's a deal.
Marvellous.
Thank you.
Drew's 30 years of dealing and his informed eye has paid off. In full view of the trade, he's managed to unearth an amazing antiques treasure.
Howard furniture, particularly their chairs, are the finest in the world. I think the Queen collects them. They're that good. You want to walk into an antique centre and find a little hidden gem, and we've managed to do that today. I don't blame her for holding out. She's a tough cookie, that's fine. I am staggered at the volume that I've been able to buy. Wonderful, wonderful pieces. Desirable, cool, tactile, comfortable. I'm over the moon.
I really enjoy it. It's nice to talk to people that like what they're doing. And that's the best bit about it.
All right.
How long did that take?
Well,
ages.
It took a while up and down the street, but yeah, it's all in.
Philip, a pleasure.
It has been an absolute
Super.
Pleasure for
Thank
me
you
too.
For today. Nice really, thank you.
Loved
Cheers.
It. Keep. I'll be back yeah. again. Well, give me another
I
month,
so.
I'll be back.
We'll
be
I really
back.
Enjoy it. Nice to see you.
See ya. Bye bye. Well, that was actually top banana, wasn't it?
Top banana.
What a day.